What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This is Dr. Hammerstein. So today we'll be doing a full comparison video between two phones. In the first corner, we have the entry level in the S21 series, the Galaxy S21 5G. And over here from the iPhone 12 series, we have the iPhone 12 mini, the entry level in the iPhone 12 series. So today we're doing a full comparison video to compare both of these phones because they are priced very similar to each other. Just to keep in mind, the iPhone 12 mini does have the same exact specs and features with the iPhone 12. It's just that the iPhone 12, of course, is a little bit bigger compared to the iPhone 12 mini. But if you guys want to get the iPhone 12 or 12 mini, just keep in mind they are both very similar. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first thing they're going to look over here is the size of the box. And as you can see here on both of these companies, they have reduced the size of this significantly. Of course, the iPhone 12 mini is much smaller compared to the S21. And yes, you don't get a charger in the box. You don't get your earphones. You don't get a free phone case. It's the same thing has been with the iPhone 12 for quite some time. With the S21, they have followed suit as well. But I got to say, in terms of the design of the box, the S21 does take it. It does look more slick. Whereas over here on the iPhone 12, it does look very similar to the iPhone 10, iPhone 11. So it's very boring with this. But over here, you got a new design. So now we're going to put this both aside and we'll check out the phones. So over here, we have the Galaxy S21. And in the other corner, we have the iPhone 12 mini. So you can see here in terms of the build and design, I have to give the first point to the iPhone 12 because yes, it does look more premium. It does feel more premium as well. You have your glass on the front and on the back. On the front here, you have your ceramic shield, which is just amazing. But over here on the S21, you have something called Gorilla Glass Victor. So in terms of protection, both are pretty similar. But of course, if you look at the back here, you have another glass. Whereas over here on the S21, you have a plastic build. So yes, it may not feel as premium as any other phone, but I gotta say it looks good, it feels good, and I already had the S20 FE, so to be honest, plastic doesn't really matter that much. But then again, some people may like that extra premium feel, so they might want to go for the iPhone 12 or 12 mini. But in the next part, Samsung does come back really, really good because they have an amazing, amazing display over here on the S21. There is no competition when it comes to the display. Over here, you have your Super Retina XDR display. It's the first time you're having an OLED screen on an iPhone. It is really nice. The colors are really good. But of course, you cannot compare this to the S21 over here, dynamic AMOLED screen. 120Hz up to HD plus settings. So it's amazing, amazing display. So what we're gonna do right now is a display test. So right now we're gonna do a display test between both of these phones, and do leave a comment down below which one you guys think look better. So now we're gonna do a speaker test on both of these phones. And yes, both of these phones are maxed out in the volume. So I'm gonna start off with the iPhone 12 mini. Thank you. So yes, for me personally, I do feel that the S21, the base is much better. The clarity is much better compared to the iPhone 12 mini. Over here, yes, with the mini, the sound is a bit more blown out. And yes, I do prefer the S21, but of course, do leave a comment down below which one you guys think did sound better. So yes, on both these phones, they do have an IP rating, so they do have water and dust resistance. And down here, you have your USB Lightning for charging, and you have your USB-C for fast charging. This one does have 25 watts of fast charging, whereas this one only supports up to 20 watts. Not very impressive from both of these companies, so not something you want to shout about. They do have wireless charging on both of them. This one, of course, does support MagSafe. It's a new feature they've added with the iPhone 12 series. So you can just slap on the back over here and it will just wirelessly charge up. You can add a phone case to it. There's a lot of accessories to it. Of course, you can do also the same thing with any Android device that supports wireless charging, but it will not stick on. It doesn't really stick on that well. But over here on the S21, what you do have is reverse wireless charging, which is a more cool feature than the MagSafe over here. So basically, if you have the AirPods Pro, if your Galaxy Buds or Buds Pro, you just pop it on the back and it will wirelessly charge up. It's a cool feature and I actually do like it on the S21. And now we're going to talk about software, which I can't say which one is the overall best. It's really depending on your preference. Over here, you have iOS 14, whereas on the S21, it's coming with One UI 3.1 on top of Android 11. There's a lot of features that both of them do have. Of course, now you have the widgets option here that you can add in the iOS 14. You have your app library. It's much better, it's much smoother on, you know, an iOS device. The apps are more optimized when it comes to like Instagram. Photos that you post are going to be more clearer compared to many other Android phones. But of course, when it comes to the Samsung device, the S21, I feel that it is one of the best stock Android-ish experience with tons more features. So yeah, I kind of contradict myself over there. But what I mean by that, you have like Samsung Pass, Samsung Pay. Of course, you have Apple Pay, you have your iCloud on this as well. You have your Quick Share on this. So it's very similar on both of these phones. But of course, this thing, you have something like a... But of course, with this thing, you have something like Samsung DeX and all this, which is really, really cool. So yes, when it comes to Apple products, it's all about the ecosystem. Once you get into it, the software is about very similar. Over here, if you want something more customizable and something like this, a Google Feed Discover, yes, I would say the Samsung S21 is a good device for that. When it comes to security, the only iPhone only has Face ID, which is a bit annoying, to be honest. And as you can see there, it doesn't really register my face that well, which again, it's going to be very annoying when it comes to people wearing face masks. Over here on the S21, you have your fingerprint, you have your face unlock, and also you can put your pattern or your pin. So it does offer you more option when it comes to security. And lastly here, we're going to talk about the cameras. Over here, you have a 10 megapixel selfie shooter. Over here on the iPhone 12, you have a 12 megapixel selfie shooter. And going on to the back, on the iPhone 12, you have a 12 megapixel main lens and an ultra wide camera, which also does come in with 12 megapixel. Over here on the S21, it's a bit better because you have a 12 megapixel shooter for its main lens. You have your ultra wide as well, 12 megapixel, and a 64 megapixel telephoto camera. So yes, it's a bit more cameras compared to the iPhone 12. So I'm going to show you some photos that I've taken on both of these phones. And of course, again, do leave a comment down below which one you guys think does give you the better shot among these two phones. So there you have it. This is the Galaxy S21 against the iPhone 12 mini or iPhone 12. If you guys find this video helpful, do click the like and smash the subscribe button down below for more videos like this in the future. Do also follow me on my social as well on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and also here on YouTube at Dr. Hamistek. So that is it. This is Dr. Hamistek. Stay safe, take care, and wash those hands.